Hello and welcome to Azure Vala YouTube channel. We are in part 45 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 79 questions in previous videos. Question number 80. You have an Azure subscription that contains a storage account named Storage 1. The storage account contains a file share named Share 1. The subscription is linked to hybrid Azure Active Directory tenant that contains security group. So security group is a Active Directory object in this case. Its name is group 1. You need to grant group 1 the storage file data SMB share elevated contributor role for the share 1. So we want to grant the permission to security group, which is the Active Directory object, to the share 1. So what should you do first? So first of all, we need to understand that if we would like to grant any individual user or any group of Active Directory account to gain the access to a specific file share, in that case we have to enable the identity based access level. So for that there would be certain steps to follow and we need to look into it. So below are the prerequisites to enable the identity based access for share in a storage account on the Active Directory. So the first one, we should have to have, you know, Active Directory tenant, which we have already. Then the second step is that enable Azure Active Directory domain services on the Azure Active Directory account, that we have to check. Okay. So the step number 2, and then there are other steps for identity based access, to enable the identity based access. And so these are the prerequisites. Let's see in the question what we have available. So what should you do first? So we start with the D. Option D says to create a private endpoint. There was nothing, no such requirement was there in the prerequisite to create a private endpoint. Option C, mount share 1 by using File Explorer. That was not mentioned as a prerequisite to enable the identity based access. Option B is grant share level permission by File Explorer. That was also not mentioned there. And option A is enable Active Directory domain services authentication for Storage 1. So definitely this is the one we do have available to enable identity based access for Active Directory user and groups. So option A is the correct answer in this case. We are in Azure portal now and we would like to see here how we can enable the Azure Active Directory domain services on the file share in storage. So we do have a storage account here, which is the Storage 1. We can go to storage account, we can go to file share, and we can enable this one here or configure the Active Directory SMB. And here we can see that we can enable from here the Azure Active Directory domain services. And also here it is mentioned that identity based access can be enabled in two steps for a particular share in this storage account. This allows individual users to use their Active Directory account to gain access to a specific file share. Next question, question number 81. You have 15 Azure subscriptions. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant that contains a security group named Group 1. You plan to purchase additional Azure subscription. You need to ensure that Group 1 can manage role assignment for the existing subscriptions and the planned subscriptions. So here we have to keep in mind that we can assign some of the permissions to Group 1, where Group 1 can manage the role assignment to different users for various existing subscription as well as the planned subscriptions. The solution must meet the following requirement. Use the principle of least privilege. and also minimize the administrative effort. There should not be many administrative effort to get the job done. What should you do? Option A, assign group 1 the owner role. Owner role is basically a full authority for a route management group. So this part is correct, that we have to provide some authority on route management group, so all the 15 subscription can be managed. So that one is correct, but owner role is the full authority actually, and which we do not need as per the use of principle of least privilege. So let's see option B. Assign group 1 the user access administrator role, which is the perfect fit for providing or managing the role assignments to other users. So this is the correct answer. And here for route management, definitely that part is also correct. So both the part are meeting. So option B is correct in this case. Third one, let's see, create a new management group. This one is incorrect, because if we create a new management group, we will have, you know, still the existing subscription and management group where we cannot provide this group 1 these roles. So that is incorrect, because there is no need of creating any new management group. Without even creating, we can assign the permission to root management group and it will do the job. Therefore the answer B is correct. So option C is incorrect. Option D, create a new management group. Again, the problem here is we don't have to create a new management group, and provide owner also is wrong, because we don't want to assign the full permissions to group 1. Therefore both the part of option D is incorrect. Also keep in mind that owner has the full access to all the resources, as well as owner can delegate the access to other users as well. But it is not the least privilege which we were looking for. Therefore it is incorrect. And user access administrator role can manage user access to Azure resources. So this is the specific role which is dedicated to manage access for the users, means they can add the user, remove the user, etc. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and press bell notification icon to receive the notification. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.